The decision of the Joint Committee on Human Fertilisation and Embryology to recommend the removal of the requirement from the Human Fertilisation and Embryology Act that treatment for women shall no longer include the provision for the need of a father has thrown government policy about the upbringing of children, and in particular the role of their parents, into question. Of the 505 published responses to the Department of Health's consultation regarding the current requirement that those involved in the IVF process must have regard for the need of any resulting children for a father, only 103 backed removing the provision. These statistics came to light as a result of research by CARE, a registered Christian charity which seeks to combine practical caring initiatives with public policy on social and ethical issues. Philippa Taylor, Care, Family and Bioethics Consultant, stated, "Academic research clearly demonstrates the importance of fathers for their children, especially boys. Indeed, as a society, we have been increasingly confronted by the problems of fatherlessness in resulting from death or family breakdown. The proposal, therefore, to deliberately create children who will be denied their father throughout childhood demonstrates a failure of judgment on the part of the government in relation to the best interests of the child. If there is any question about the effective working of the current arrangements, then we must improve the delivery mechanisms associated with the father's clause, not remove it." But they are not the only people concerned by the government's seemingly high-handed approach to the welfare of children. Baroness Deitch, crossbencher, independent adjudicator for higher education and former chair of the Human Fertilisation and Embryology Authority, has criticised the proposed change in three respects. Firstly, our law states that children's need for a father should be considered. To remove that requirement is to make a fresh statement to the effect that the child does not need a father. It sends a message, insofar as legislation does that, to men at a time when many of them feel undermined as providers and parents, a message to contrary to government policy in this field. Secondly, the current law is not a prohibition. It does no more than cause potential patients and their clinicians to reflect on the situation that has presented itself and ask whether all will be well, or as well as can be predicted if a baby is born. We still do not accept underage marriage or polygamous or incestuous marriages. It is the hallmark of a civilized society that it lays down certain conditions for family formation in order to protect mother and children. Thirdly, there is a wealth of research that shows that children need fathers, not just as parent or parents. They need to see complementary roles in the relationship between the sexes, a microcosm of society as they are growing up. This is not to stigmatize single parents who do a very good job raising their children. Nevertheless, the optimal conditions are two parents. Baroness Deitch concludes by stating, "We should not let fear of being accused of being politically incorrect detract from standing up for what is best for the child and for our society. The need for a father provision should remain." But it is not simply religious organisations or those sitting in the House of Lords that have expressed disquiet over the government's stance on the proposed legislation. Dan Butcher, Director of Parliamentary Affairs, said, "These findings are the source of real concern given the government has clearly ignored the balance of consultation responses and gone out on a limb, developing a draft bill which, if implemented, will remove the father's provision." Claire Thomas, MP, stated, "It is a matter of great concern that the government has not listened properly to the people of the UK. Whilst there is no question that consultations are plebiscites, there is also no question that if government ignores consultation responses in this cavalier manner, people will have good reason not to bother with consultations and our politics will become very much the poorer. The overwhelming evidence demonstrating the importance of fathers affirms the wisdom of the balance of the consultation process." Why do fathers dress up as comic book heroes and climb tall buildings? It was John F. Kennedy who said, "Those who make peaceful revolution impossible make violent revolution inevitable." Although campaigners are careful to distance themselves from extreme action, whilst the government seems oblivious to the welfare of children and their right to both parents, many fathers feel compelled to protest in this way.